Hi everyone, I'm Amanda and welcome back or welcome to my channel. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make these crochet baby mittens. They're really cute. They have a little bobble stitch trim. And the cuff has a stretchy ribbing. In this tutorial, I'll give you the instructions to make three sizes. Size newborn, 0 to 3 months, and 3 to 6 months. There's also a preemie size here. If you would like to make this age, then please click on the free written pattern, which I'll link to below the video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. There are also subtitles on all of my tutorials. Just click on the little gear icon at the bottom of the video, select subtitles, and then select the language of your preference. These crochet baby mittens are part of a little set, so there's a matching bobble stitch cardigan. A matching baby hat. It also has a stretchy ribbing and a little pom-pom. And there's some matching baby booties. The set here in the yellow is age 3 to 6 months, but the set has been designed from age preemie up to 2 years of age. And lastly, there's a matching baby blanket. And it's a lovely, soft and squishy bobble stitch baby blanket. I'll put links to all of these other tutorials below the video. And you can also find them in the free written patterns on my website. So to make these crochet baby mittens, you'll need a light worsted double knit yarn. I used Paint Box Yarns Baby Double Knit. It's a really soft blend of acrylic and nylon. For size newborn, you'll need to use a 3 mm crochet hook. For size 0 to 3 months, you'll need to use an E 3.5 mm hook. For 3 to 6 months, you'll need a G 4 mm hook. You'll also need a stitch marker, a pair of scissors, and a tapestry needle for weaving in your ends. I'll put links to all the materials I used below the video in the description box. Before we begin, remember that this tutorial, like all my other videos, has been divided up into chapters. If you would like to jump to a particular section of the video, then please click on the relevant timestamp. You'll find all this information in the description box below the video. To begin, make a chain of 4. So there's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we're going to slip stitch to the first chain to form a ring. So to the first chain here, join with a slip stitch. And then we're going to, for round number 1, we'll work our stitches into the middle of the ring. So right in here. So for round number 1, make a chain of 2. So there's 1 and 2. And then we're going to work 8 half double crochet into the centre of the ring. So there's one. And I'm just going to pop a stitch marker into the top of that first half double crochet. And when you're working your half double crochets, work over this little tail here. So there's two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. And then to join the round, I'm just going to slip stitch into that first half double crochet to join. And then I'm just going to pull on the yarn tail that we've been working over, and I'm just going to pull it tight to close the gap in the middle. So at the end of round number one, you should have 8 half double crochet. For round two, chain two, one and two, and then we're going to work 2 half double crochet into the same stitch. So I'll just show you with my needle. It will be into this stitch here, which is right at the base of the chain two. So there's one, and then another one back into the same stitch. And then I'm going to get my stitch marker and I'm just going to put it into the top of the first half double crochet. So there's one and two. And then I'm going to work 2 half double crochet into the next 7 stitches. So into the next stitch here, we'll work 1 half double crochet, and then another one back into the same stitch. Then into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet. Oops. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet, 2 half double crochet into the following stitch, two into the next stitch. And then into the last stitch here, 2 half double crochet. So there's one and 2. So at the end of round number 2, you should have 16 half double crochet. So if we just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. 16 half double crochet. And then to join the round, I'm just going to slip stitch into that first half double crochet to join. For round number 3, begin by chaining 2. So there's 1 and 2. And then we're going to work 2 half double crochet into the same stitch. So it will be in here at the base of the chain 2. So there's 1 and then another 1 back into the same stitch. So there's 2. And then I'm going to pop my stitch marker into the first half double crochet. So there's 1 and 2. And then into the next stitch, I'm going to work 1 half double crochet. So into the next stitch here. And then basically this is the sequence that we're going to be repeating all the way around. So it will be 2 half double crochet into the next stitch and then 1 half double crochet into the following stitch. So we'll do this sequence for another 7 times. So into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet. So there's 1 and then another 1 back into the same stitch. And then into the next stitch, we'll work 1 half double crochet. So we'll do that again. 2 half double crochet into the next stitch. And then 1 half double crochet into the following stitch. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet. And 1 half double crochet into the next stitch. 2 half double crochet into the next stitch. And then 1 half double crochet into the following stitch. 2 into the next stitch. And then 1 into the next stitch. Into the following stitch, we'll work 2 half double crochet. One into the next stitch. And then 2 half double crochet into the next stitch. And into the last stitch here, we'll work 1 half double crochet. So at the end of round number 3, you should have 24 half double crochet. So we'll begin counting from the first stitch here. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So there's our 24 half double crochet, and then I'm just going to slip stitch into the first half double crochet to join the round. For the next round, which is round number 4, this is the round that we're going to be repeating. So begin by chaining 2, 1 and 2, and then we're going to work one half double crochet into the same stitch. So into this stitch here, right at the base of the chain 2, work one half double crochet. And I'm just going to pop my stitch marker into the top of that stitch. And then I'm going to work one half double crochet into the next 23 stitches. So into the next stitch. So there's one. Two, three, four, five, six, and 23 into the last stitch here. So at the end of round number 4, you should have 24 half double crochet. So if we begin counting from the first one, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the first half double crochet. So I have 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4 rounds so far. So for rounds 5 to 9, you're going to repeat the last round, round number 4. So you'll begin by chaining 2. You'll work one half double crochet into the same stitch. And then you'll work one half double crochet into the next 23 stitches. And then you'll slip stitch to the first half double crochet to join. So that's the round 4 repeat. So as I say, work rounds 5 to 9 by repeating round number 4. I'll do this off camera and I'll meet you back once I've worked my 9 rounds. I've just finished working round number 9. So if we begin counting from here, this was our first round, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. There's my 9 rounds. So when you finish round number 9, you're going to chain 1, and then you're going to turn your work. And this is because we'll be working our bobble stitches, and when we work the bobble stitches, we'll be working with the wrong side of the work facing us. So we're going to work one single crochet into the first single crochet. So when you work in the round like this, after you turn your work, it can be a little bit tricky to figure out what the first stitch is that you should be working into. So the easiest way to remember it is to work into the third chain from your hook. So if we count 1, two, and three. This is the first stitch that you should be working into. So into this first stitch, we're going to work one single crochet. And then grab your stitch marker and just pop it into the top of that first single crochet. And then we're going to work one single crochet into the next single crochet. So into the next stitch here, work a single crochet. And then we're going to work on the repeat for the round. So into the next single crochet here, we're going to work a bobble stitch. And to work the bobble stitch, you're going to yarn over hook, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook, one, two, and three. Yarn over and pull through the first two loops. You'll have two loops on your hook. Then yarn over, insert your hook back into the same stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops. You'll have three loops on your hook. Then yarn over, insert your hook back into the same stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have five loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops. You'll have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, insert your hook back into the same stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have six loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops. You'll have five loops on your hook. And it's when you have five loops on your hook that you'll yarn over and pull through all five loops. And that's the bobble stitch completed. And it shows up on the right side of your work. We're then going to work one single crochet into the next two single crochet. So into the next single crochet here, work a single crochet. And then one into the next single crochet. You can see the bobble a little bit better. So this is the sequence that you're going to be repeating all the way around for round number 10. You'll work one bobble and then two single crochet. So I'll do the sequence with you again. One bobble in the next single crochet. And then one single crochet into the next two single crochet. So into the next stitch here, a single crochet. And then another single crochet back into this next stitch here. So one bobble and then two single crochet. So repeat this sequence all the way around for round number 10. Until you have one stitch left, and I'll work the last stitch with you. So I'll do this off camera and I'll work the last stitch with you at the end of the round. I've been working the sequence of one bobble and then two single crochet all the way around. I have one stitch remaining, which is right in here. This is your last stitch. So into this last stitch, I'm going to work one bobble stitch. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the first single crochet. And at the end of this round, you should have 8 bobble stitches in total. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. For round number 11, begin by chaining 1 and then turn your work. And then we're going to work 1 single crochet into the next bobble stitch. So remember, the first stitch that you should be working into is the 3rd chain from your hook. So if we count 1, 2, and 3, this is the first stitch here and it's the top of our bobble stitch. And then I'm going to pop my stitch marker into that first single crochet. And then I'm going to work 1 single crochet into the next 2 single crochet. So into this single crochet, I'll work a single crochet. And then into the next single crochet, which is in here, which is tucked just behind this bobble stitch, I'm going to work a single crochet. So this is the repeat that you're going to be working all the way around for round number 11. You'll work 1 single crochet into the next bobble and then 1 single crochet into the next 2 single crochet. So I'll do that with you again. 1 single crochet into the next bobble. So this is your bobble. This is the top of your bobble here. And then 1 single crochet into the next 2 single crochet. So into the next single crochet here. And then 1 in here. Into the next bobble, a single crochet. And then 1 into the next 2 single crochet. So repeat this sequence all the way around for round number 11 and I'll meet you at the end of this round. I've been working the sequence all the way around, so I thought I would just work the last sequence with you. So as before, work 1 single crochet into the next bobble stitch and then 1 single crochet into the next 2 single crochet. And we're at the end of the round. And to join the round, we're just going to slip stitch into that first single crochet to join. And at the end of this round, number 11, you should have 24 single crochet. For round number 12, begin by chaining 1 and then turn your work. And then we're going to work 1 bobble stitch into the first single crochet. So remember, the first stitch is the 3rd chain from your hook. So counting 1, 2, and 3, this is the first stitch, so we'll work a bobble stitch in here. And then I'm just going to pop my stitch marker into the top of that bobble stitch, so just through the top here. And then we're going to work on the repeat. So to begin the repeat, you'll work one single crochet into the next two single crochet. So into the next single crochet here, work a single crochet, and then one single crochet into the next single crochet. And then we'll work one bobble stitch into the next single crochet. So this is the sequence, one single crochet into the next two single crochet, and then one bobble stitch into the next single crochet. So I'll do it with you again, one single crochet into the next two single crochet. And then one bobble stitch into the next single crochet. So repeat this sequence all the way around for round number 12. And you, when you get to the end of the round, you should have two stitches remaining. So work your two single crochet and then your bobble all the way around until you have two stitches remaining. And I'll work the last two stitches with you. I've been working the sequence of two single crochet and then one bobble all the way around, and I have two stitches remaining, so one and two. Into these last two stitches, I'm going to work one single crochet. So a single crochet in here, and then a single crochet into the last stitch here. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the top of the first bobble. And at the end of round number 12, you should have 8 bobble stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. There's my 8 bobble stitches. For round number 13, begin by chaining 1 and then turn your work. And then we're going to work one half double crochet into the first single crochet. So the first single crochet will be the third chain from your hook. So counting 1, 2, and 3, this is the first stitch. So we'll work a half double crochet in here. And then we'll pop a stitch marker into that first half double crochet. And then we'll work a half double crochet into the next single crochet. So right in here. And then we're going to work on the repeat. So we'll work one half double crochet into the next bobble stitch. So here's our bobble. This is the top in here. So one half double crochet in here. And then one half double crochet in the next two single crochet. So one half double crochet into the next stitch. And then one half double crochet into the next single crochet here. So I'll do it with you one more time. One half double crochet into the next bobble. And then one half double crochet into the next two single crochet. So repeat this sequence all the way around for round number 13. until you have one stitch remaining, and I'll work the last stitch with you. I've come to the end of round number 13, so I worked a half double crochet into the bobble and then one half double crochet into the next two single crochet, and I have one stitch remaining, which is my bobble stitch. So into this last stitch here, I'm going to work my last half double crochet. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the first half double crochet. And at the end of round number 13, you should have 24 half double crochet stitches. For the next round, round number 14, begin by chaining 2, 1 and 2, but do not turn your work. And we're going to begin the round by working one front post half double crochet in the next stitch. So the first stitch that we work into will be this half double crochet here. And to work the front post half double crochet, you're going to yarn over hook, bring your hook to the front, and then at the side of this stitch, push your hook through the space to the back, and then bring it out through the other side of the stitch, through the space here. And this stitch should be lying over the front of your hook here. Then you're going to yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all three loops. And that's the front post half double crochet. And we've made that around this first stitch here. And then grab your stitch marker and pop it into the top of that stitch. And then we're going to work a back post half double crochet around the next stitch here. So to work the back post half double crochet, yarn over hook, then bring your hook to the back of your work, and then bring it through to the front, through the space here at the side of that next stitch, and then push your hook through to the back so that this next stitch is now lying over the back of your hook. Then yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all three loops. And that's the back post half double crochet. So this is the sequence that you're going to be repeating around for round number 14. So you'll work one front post half double crochet in the next stitch. And then one back post half double crochet around the next stitch. So I'm going to repeat this sequence off camera all the way around for round number 14, and I'll meet you at the end of the round. I'm coming to the end of round number 14, and I'll just work the last two stitches with you, which is this one and this one here. So I just worked a front post and then a back post. So I'm going to work a front post, half double crochet, and then a back post half double crochet around the last stitch here. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the top of that first front post half double crochet. And at the end of round number 14, you should have 12 front post half double crochet stitches and 12 back post half double crochet stitches. For the next two rounds, rounds 15 and 16, these are the last two rounds of our little mitten, you're simply going to repeat round number 14, so the last round here. So for rounds 15 and 16, you'll repeat round number 14 by chaining two, one and two, and then you'll work one front post half double crochet in the next stitch. So here's the next stitch here, which is our front post half double crochet. And then one back post half double crochet. So around this back post half double crochet, we'll work another back post half double crochet. So just the same as round number 14, one front post and then one back post. And then when you get to the end of the round, you'll slip stitch into the top of that first front post half double crochet to join. So I'm going to work up rounds 15 and 16 off camera, and I'll meet you once I've completed round number 16, which is the last round. I've just finished working rounds 15 and 16. So this is what your little ribbed cuff should be looking like. And when you come to the end of round number 16, you're just going to grab your scissors and cut your yarn and then fasten off. So just chain one, pull the yarn through, and then thread that little yarn tail through your tapestry needle, and then just weave this little tail end in into the inside of your work. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks so much for watching.